How is it going, everyone? Welcome to Demon Turf Neon Splash, a game that is a continuation of another game that I did not play called, well, Demon Turf. But I didn't play that one because it seems that that one is more oriented in combat, while this one is just oriented in running. So I preferred this one, which means that, well, that. Reason why it's in the middle of a dialogue is because the game for some reason doesn't start with a main menu, but it's okay. Don't worry about it. So apparently I'm Bibsy and I'm a demon, and someone here found a painting. Looks like one of those paintings in Mario 64. This a kappa? This Midshi guy? Hey Blue, how is it going? I didn't even touch it, I just got close. I don't know if the sound is fine either, because it didn't let me test it. Oh, now we're in the main menu, okay. Pretty cool, took you a little. This is spoilers, of course. Okay, I think that... Well, you can actually increase the audio, but I don't know if it's fine or not. But for now, I guess let's just get into it. Apparently, you get straight into a level. So there was gonna be more, but nope. Okay. So you move with this, you jump... Oh, you can triple jump. Wait, it has vibration. Wait, give me a second. How do I disable? Well, I guess I need to exit. But a vibration is a... It's a no-go. I'm assuming it's gonna be in controls. Yeah. Why do so many games like having vibration, dude? We'll stick around for the first day. Yeah, don't worry about it. Let me check, first of all, the sound to see if it's fine. Seems to be fine. Let me know if you want it to be louder or something. That's something that we will see more later. I'm assuming that here we won't see much. Okay, so what do I need to do? Pick up these things? Is that what I need to do? What about this guy? Alright. Pretty interesting that you are 2D. Wait, you die in the water? You can swim? But dude, this is a pool. It's not like it's an ocean where you drown. You die in a pool? Alright. I don't think this demon really has too much demonic shit. That's not really sitting, that's just, you know, laying down, but sure. Okay, can I wall jump? Because this guy, okay, yeah, I can wall jump. What a shover, I know. Oh, fuck. And she says, come on. Yeah, that's what I say, that's my line. Okay, here you have the actual tip. So you have a regular jump. A double jump. Well, we figure out this much. And double jump again. Yeah. We know that. So what about this? Jump and what? This flutter, okay. Jump and then spin in the air. Wait, you hold left trigger. What does it say? Spin in the air to cover extra distance. I'm not sure if I understand the way the spin works. Reminds you of SRV2 or those Doom games. Well, yeah, I mean, having 2D in a 3D world is pretty interesting. But yeah, some Nintendo 64 games did that. What I'm not sure is... how does this work? Jump and then spin in the air to cover extra distance, but... It feels like in this particular place, the opposite of what you want to do is spinning, because these platforms are here. Whatever. If you don't double jump but spin first, then jump out of the spin, you will perform a very long super jump. Okay. These are some complete instructions. There is... Wait, are those things that I need to pick up there? Or are they just decoration? I can't tell. Well, the wall jump we already know. I'm not even sure what picking up all these things do. Look at the circular drop. Yeah, I know, I know. Why am I leaking? Good question. I don't know, actually. I guess I'm a demon. Damn it. Am I dead? I am dead. Fuck. If only the devil could swim. It seems that she can't. Alright, that's fine. It's one of those games where you need to get used to the controls, because it seems that so far it's a lot to digest. Oh, there are things up there. I don't even know what happens if you pick all these things up. Like, in fact, I don't even know if I should go for all those collectibles or to go for the time bonus. Like, I don't know what each gives me. So... considering how bad I am with collectibles and completion, I'm assuming that... Wait, what's this? A slide? Oh, damn it. Yeah, you can control it. So I lost one of these things. I don't know what these things are supposed to be. Lollipops? But I don't see what else they could be. I mean, they have to. So, is the sound fine, or should it be louder? Because I can make it louder. Like, can you hear the music well and everything well? And you're spoiling the previous game. Well, you can't really tell. Well, the game has... Well, the problem is that you cannot change the options in the middle of a level. But the game can... What you mean the music probably sucks? Spin to break those sweet crystals. Wait, is spinning my attack? Seems that it's my only attack. There is also this thing, it's... Wait, oh, that wasn't a platform. Oh, my bad. There also doesn't seem to be checkpoints, but... No, I think that you need to set the checkpoints. You can see up there, it says set a flag on the top left for some reason. Well, maybe they mentioned that in some place that I didn't see. Bad level design. You really love saying that, don't you? But yeah. No, I mean, it's a matter of getting used to it. It's just that this game is probably thought... is thought. I mean that it's something that is made... Damn it, fucking flies. With people that play the previous game in mind. I will assume that people that play the previous game already know how to control pretty well. Can I jump from here? No, doesn't look like it. I probably should set up a checkpoint after the slide. Because redoing this, it seems like I already picked everything up here. Wait, how did I not pick that up? Did I really not pick this one up? Or are they just appearing here to make me, you know, I feel like these are appearing here just to make me feel good, or rather to not make me feel bad. Oh, it makes it easy to know where I've been. Yeah, I guess that's the reason for the leaking. Quite funny though, I gotta say. Okay, so should I set up a flag here? If I set a flag... How many flags can I even set? Two? Or how many? What's this? Nothing. Okay. So I need to get to that way. What's this? Pin to break? Oh no, I already seen that. That's an obstacle. Like the animation? Yeah, the animation is pretty well done. A lot of frames. Okay, I can reach this from here. But what is it? It's like a music CD. Well, the way it looks makes it look like a vinyl more than a CD. Hey, same concept. They are both discs. Hey, I'm not sure what's the point of collecting this, because I think that the idea is to beat the levels fast, which is kind of like the opposite of what I'm doing. That was bound to happen. Oh, they reappear. So somehow to reappear when I die. But, yeah. I don't know if I'm supposed to beat these levels this slow. It says yummy. Are you calling our number one chatter? You probably shouldn't. Don't want to call him here. Okay. Look for sweets. Wait. Oh, you pressed this? Wait, what? Oh, it points. It creates an arrow that points to them. And then what does it say? Don't forget to place your checkpoints. Well, I already placed a checkpoint. Can I place another one? Well, apparently you can place how many of these you want, because if that's the case, how do you even die? Well, no, I know how you die, but I mean, couldn't you theoretically place a checkpoint in every step you take? Or am I missing something? Okay, this thing is rotating quite a lot. What do I get if I get all the candies? Uh-oh. Okay. Seems that the spin is pretty important. No, damn it. I think all of the remaining ones are here. No. Or are they? Yeah, they are. Okay, I actually got them all. Problem is that doing it like this, you take a very long time in beating them. It says pause for moves. What do you mean pause for moves? More details? I don't see any details. It's okay. Hey Yami, how is it going? Yeah, number one chatter, you hear me right? Alright. Now, something that I want to say is enhance the sound all the way up. That you can do here, actually. You can go insane with this. There you go. Full volume. But hopefully it's fine. But I guess that you can play it once, like a level for completion, and then play it to get the medals. It's just that I'm not very good at playing fast. In number one tsundere, I agree. I'm not sure what I should prioritize. I should prioritize... I should prioritize being fast or being a collectionist. Okay, that's a dash. That's a different button. If you press L1, you do that. It's a dash. And then you have... Oh, you turn into Sonic if you press R1. Oh, shit, okay. That seems very fast. And by very fast, I mean that it feels very hard to control. But I'm not sure, because they are both very different ways of playing the game. Like, either doing it as fast as you can or collecting everything, and I'm pretty sure that they are mutually exclusive. Well, there is probably one speedrunner that does both at the same time, but I mean... You know what I say about speedrunners. Why do you tell me to place the checkpoint? What if I don't? What are you gonna do? Are you gonna cry? Oh, well, the good thing is that if you place a checkpoint, you can go back to a previous place and then teleport. I'm not sure what was the button to teleport. I think it was square. No, not square. Well, it says reset to flag. Oh, you can kill yourself. Nice. So you kill yourself to go to the... to the flag. Interesting. That's indeed something that a devil will do. So these platforms... Oh, they are conveyors. That's where they... why they were so fast. Alright. And these are falling platforms. Well, more like disappearing platforms. They just dissolve. There is more up there. Can I go up there? Not sure. Cox. I'm still not dead. Oh, nice. See, that was on purpose. That's what I meant to do. But once you're down there, you're dead. I don't think there is any way to go back. Wait, what is this teleport for? Wait. Oh, you can teleport between flags. Okay. Interesting feature. A little bit hard to find the right perspective, though. When you are 2D and the obstacles are 3D. Maybe a little bit hard to find exactly the place. I'm surprised that the game still hasn't told me about the dash. Like, it seems like a very important mechanic, if you ask me. Can you step on this? Doesn't look like it. In fact, I'm stuck. There you go. No, if I want to go up there, I probably need to go some other way. But I'm not sure where. Well, I'm assuming it's from here. Fuck. Damn it. That's a cool falling. But yeah, no. You weren't supposed to do that. Well, the good thing is that... once you... wait, this is not dead. So it's very hard to control. And I got hit. Damn it. But yeah, you don't have to worry about spoilers, Blue. There doesn't seem to be much story. Well, unless you care about the level designs. In which case, yes. But... that net choose through bitrate? I mean... usually things that have a lot of things that change, you know, the surroundings affect bitrate. Things that are like grid shape, usually, yeah, destroy the bitrate. Well, it doesn't help that the whole world has like some... I think they call it a chromatic aberration. I'm not mistaken. Wait, what? Wait, how didn't I land there? I'm getting scammed. Jumping kills your speed? I don't think that jumping kills your speed. See? You can keep your momentum, just that you probably have to dash beforehand. Not to mention that you also have this Sonic roll. I'm pretty sure that if you do this... Well, just that doing it here, it's probably not the smartest idea. But yeah, I guess it keeps your momentum. I mean, I think that the movement of this game has the potential to be extremely... complex. Like, if you want to go fast, especially in these levels, the bitrate is... What am I saying? Yeah, the bitrate. Definitely relevant to the conversation. No, I mean the... I'm stoned. Well, it's Friday. What you want me to do? No, if you want to go fast through a level, you can probably do a lot to go faster. Like, it looks like it's one of those systems that it's just hard to master. I will say easy to... Oh, this is... Okay, you want a checkpoint? Is there something up there? No, doesn't look like it. Right. Wait. Why do they put these things on a... I'm trying to hit it, there you go. I don't know why they put these things in a fast section. Like, it makes sense if they put it here in the middle. Why they put it at the side? Kinda kills your momentum. Oh fuck, wrong button. It's a little bit hard to incorporate into my game plan the... how it's called? The... spin? I think they call it. Well, the problem is that there are two spins. One that you do horizontally and the other one that you do vertically. Now, I'm talking about the horizontal one. Like, I find it hard to incorporate that into my brain. Wait, is that the ending? Well, according to this, it seems like... Yeah, I will say that this looks like the end, probably. Well, the issue is that I haven't picked up all of these things. I don't know how much I'm lacking. Do you have something to say? Try to find some snacks. I have 73. The playground in the main menu. Before worrying about that... Wait, is there something up here? Damn it, am I dead? No. No, I am dead. Or maybe not. Actually, when you are in a slippery surface, you can just jump again to and dash. Wait, but what's the point of this? There is nothing here. Well, what's the point of these platforms? But unfortunately, I don't have all the candies yet. Damn it. Where could they possibly be? Because I gotta assume that this is the end of the level. Just that... Wasn't the end of the level in the previous level different than this? Wait, oh, it's a ring race. Okay, a ring race, but... Oh, okay, the amount of rings is... Well, okay, so this was the point of this. So it says race, but I don't see any time limit. Oh, okay, that's the time limit. Oh, come on! Why is there even an obstacle there? I should set a checkpoint. Sonic goes it. I should play that game, dude. Yeah, this is pretty clearly a Sonic fan game. In case you had your doubts, this is very clearly a Sonic fan game. Oh, it's a little bit hard to get into these platforms. Come on! Got it. Oh, so you needed to do that in order to continue the level. So I don't know why the tutorial said ring equals okay. Why don't you tell me what it does? That's fine. At least we know. Okay, and those are the last crystals. So I did get all of the crystals. Nice. Then on to this. Yeah, there are so many ways of doing this fast. So the end level is always the frame. I should not. Why not? What's the worst that could happen? It's fine. We're gonna have lots of fun. Okay, what's this? Rollout. Yeah, I already learned about this, but... Hold the input to enter rollout. Wait, what the hell? You will go real fast. Yeah, but why is that covering shit? Use your camera... What? Oh, come on! Really? Use your camera for sharp turns and press forward back to adjust the speed. That sounds complex. Okay. Hey, before I do that, I need to pick up these things. Is there something up there? No. Well, then again, if you want to know where these things are, you can just press the analog. That I'm not a very big fan of pressing the analog. Okay, so... Come on. That's pretty fast. Okay, you can stop at any time. You're off. Alright, have a good one, Blue. Rollout champ. Yeah, I know that. Enter and exit a drift. Oh shit. Wait, but. Enter and exit a rollout quickly to drift around sharp corners. Can you really call that a drift? Isn't that more like braking? That sounds more like braking to me. Than drifting. Well, it said quickly. Yeah, I can see what you mean. Like, you can kind of spam it. Yeah, okay, I gotcha. Yeah, that's an interesting mechanic. Okay, should I set a checkpoint here or what? I don't even know if I miss anything. But you can always go back to the beginning of the stage anyways. Okay, why is this ceiling bouncy? It looks quite sturdy to be that bouncy. I don't know. Alright. Seems like I can enter here. Oh, but we have Mr. Secret here. And only here. They explain what they are. Do you know collecting this unlock remits versions of each level? I didn't see any unlock. Maybe I wasn't paying attention. I skip all of this. I don't know if it's a good idea to have a lot of these candies fly. Like, flying the way they do, it's a little bit weird. Especially when they fly up and down. Because sometimes you think there's nothing there, but it's just that they didn't move where you are. Well, or at least not inside of your field of vision. I don't think I'm missing anything here. Well, you can always, as the game says, press the analog. And it already points, okay. It points forward, so. What is this? Glide dash. Yeah, I know that. Yeah, I'm assuming that all these moves in the previous games are probably power-ups you unlock through the game. Wait, does this kill you? It does. I didn't expect that. Oh, and I'm back at the beginning because I didn't set a checkpoint. I should set the checkpoints more often, even if it doesn't suggest me to do so. It's for the best. So you can beat the levels. Well, in this case, this is supposed to be a place without obstacles, so doing something like this is doable, but... Uh-oh. I mean, no. Oof. What a save. I should set a checkpoint probably... like, up there, after I... after the dash tutorial. I'm also not sure when you not put a checkpoint. Why is there a red flag? Is it the game telling you that you should put a checkpoint or you're gonna die? Oh, I can set a flag here. But wait, where can you set a flag? Wait, why is this fine but not this? Is it because of the surface? You cannot set a checkpoint whenever you want. Wherever you want. Also, I think it's important when you set the checkpoint to look in the direction you wanna look after you respawn. Otherwise, you will have to manually turn around every single time. That doesn't seem like a good thing. Seem like wait, is this thing going down? Wait, it is going down. I just realized a little bit late. I'm not sure when it starts going down though, because here it's just standing still. At some point, well, I think right there it started already. Yeah, right now it's going down. At some point it starts doing that, and it just doesn't stop. What's at the top? Am I safe or is it still going down? No, it is still going down. Okay. Oh no, but it stops once it reaches here, okay. Cannot I open this chest? Well, then again, the only valuable things you can collect are the vinyls and the candies. There is no gold. Well, the only gold that you get here is by beating the level fast. But that's not what I'm doing. I'm doing the opposite of beating the levels fast. I'm just doing them slow. Not on purpose, but seems that collecting everything without going slow is just messed up. Wait, what's this? Okay, I know what that is now. So you know that in some games, they make the spike so big, I really have to ask myself, if those spikes were in real life, would they hurt? Because they are so big that at that point they wouldn't impale you or anything like that. They would just be there, and that's it. Uh-oh. Damn it. That didn't work. Wait. That doesn't seem like... I didn't realize that way. Yeah, but this checkpoint sets me back quite a bit. Yeah, I have to remember to set checkpoints. Just that that's something that I'm not used to do. Like, in most games that I play, checkpoints are set by the game. I usually don't worry about that, but in this game you have to. I'm gonna try to remember, but it's hard. Especially since I still don't know when a checkpoint is valid and when a checkpoint is not valid. Will I try this? This is like a bad idea. Yeah, maybe I should set the checkpoint. Well, you can set it here. Whether that's a good idea or not, I don't know, but at least you can set it there. Alright. How do I do this jump? Like this? No, even doing that doesn't work. To reset to flag, but yeah, I'm not sure about that one. I mean, probably supposed to do a dash like this, or a combination of both things. Or unless you are supposed to do this whole section as a ball, maybe. No, that works. No, I think what's happening is that these platforms are moving. It's hard to tell, but I think that they are moving like up and down. Wait, is there? No, that's my shadow. Oh, a very weird shadow, I gotta say. Got it? Alright. I am a beast. Beat all Neon Beach levels. Oh, that was a zone? Damn. I already have 10% completion. I think that this might be all the levels in the game. It says switch to Remix levels. And this is the whole thing. Well, the reviews in Steam say the game was short, but damn. Hey Kyle, how is it going? Just here being a devil. Oh, since you are the one that is a sound expert, can you tell me if the sound is fine? Yummy. Is the sound fine or is the sound not fine? Oh, and the creator seems like it's a weeb. How many indie weeb creators have we seen in a row? This is like the menacing aura from Shosho, and this just says ramen. Fucking weaves. Seems okay. Okay, thank you. Damn, okay, yeah, this is the Japan area. Man, every indie creator is a weave. I can't believe it. How is that possible? How did they let that happen? Uh-oh. That didn't go well. Come on. Okay. Like, so far, the games that I played recently were Super Galaxy Squadron. Then it was Wanderling DX, and now this game. All of those creators are weebs. Can you believe that? Uh-oh. I really fucked that one up, because that platform is now gonna fall. Well, then again, both are kinda gonna fall at the same time. Yeah, no, that wasn't a good idea. But hey, at least I already picked all of that up. Hey, come on, Super Galaxy Squadron is an okay game. Just that you have too many expectations. You gotta temper your expectations. Usually, when it comes to indie games, you know? Uh-oh. Okay. Wait, how do I pick up these things? Oh, it's one of these that go up and down. Problem is that these platforms are so goddamn slow. Not to mention that... Yeah, I think that this is the only way to pick them up. At them. Like... You're really gonna be here a long ass time to pick them all up. At least there is a way to do this faster, but I don't think there is. Because you risk, you know. Sounds better in Spanish. A lot of things sound better in Spanish. But yeah. What was I about to say? Oh yeah! About Continuum Shift, you know that I extracted all of the save files from my PlayStation 3? Well, and that obviously includes Continuum Shift. But unfortunately, well, as expected, it's not compatible with the Steam game. So, yeah. Uh-oh, I'm there. Oh, and I forgot to set a checkpoint, dammit. Forgot the damn checkpoint. I keep forgetting about it. I just can't help it. Where was the place here? But yeah, that's a shame because I play that game so much. But I think that there is one more thing that I can try. Apparently you can kind of hack your own save files to make them usable in every device. But the problem is that by every device, it means every PlayStation 3. So, whether it's gonna work on Steam or not, something tells me it won't. But you never know. But yeah, it's a little bit of a shame if it doesn't work. Then again, for what I need to do, it's not like I need to have my save file. It will be nice if I try to do Abyss. But yeah. Wait, are these disappearing blocks? No. But wait, what do you do here? Wait, I should set up a checkpoint before I forget. Set the checkpoint. But what is this? Because... Oh, okay, they are like sticky walls. Oh, and she's here. For sure. Damn. Yeah, I've been collecting those vinyls. So I don't know where the vinyl in this stage is gonna be. I think that the other... some of the other vinyls weren't that easy to see. I saw them by accident. Something tells me that I might miss something here. What does it say that? Wait, give me a second. Uh-oh. No, I'm fine. It says Oni Cafe, right? I'm not sure if that's the kanji for Oni, but I think it is. Wait, what's this? Okay, platforms. Yeah, I don't see any vinyl so far. Yeah, I guess that's one of those things that I was kinda taking for granted. Since I found them easily, but I think that they might be pretty hard to find. Oh, wait, there are candies here. Oh, damn it, and I missed the top one, really? Oh, that reminds me I should set a checkpoint before I die again. Set it here. I should set it there. Well, in fact, we can take that and just respawn very easily. There you go, see? Easy. I don't think I can go up there, though. It's too high. I'm supposed to go down. Don't miss the candies. And now what? It's supposed to... Oh, I'm supposed to board that thing. Is there nothing down there? Well, there is death. Then again, if I'm a demon, shouldn't I look for death? Isn't death a good thing for a demon? What do you have to say? Wait, what mods? They mentioned something about a playground, but I have no idea what that is about. Like, if I went in the main menu, there was a playground thingy. Oh, I missed that one. That's what I mean with these flying candies. Just very, very hard to see them. Oh, and I'm supposed to tilt this one. Well, not really that necessary. But yeah, I need to find the vinyl. I don't know where the vinyl is. Maybe down here? No. Because the level is about to be over. Uh-oh. Level is about to be over and I still have not seen the vinyl at all. I just don't see it. Maybe I'm blind. Well, there's also the fact that it's pretty... Sometimes it's a little bit hard to see things with so much chromatic aberration going. Well, at least I got all the candies, but yeah, not the vinyl. The vinyl is in some weird place. Though, something that you can do is set the checkpoints and teleport between them. And maybe I could find it. Or maybe... Oh, actually, it's here, isn't it? Unless this place somehow has something else. But what else could it have? Oh. What do you... Okay, no, it does have the vinyl. Nice. I didn't even need to... Well, I guess actually putting the checkpoint there... Putting the checkpoint there is useful so I can just go back there. And that's it. Nice. Got it. Alright. So far, so good. I'm actually completing the levels fully. Well, except for the time thingy. Okay, where is the playground, though? Oh, playground. LB. Well, the L1. For what I'm using. So the playground. Okay, there is a lot to learn. Camera mode. This is so stupid, but also kind of cute. I mean, it's stupid because you're not even there. You're just turning around on purpose, are you? Well, but you keep telling me about your mods, but I don't see any mods. You mean Twitch mods? We don't want those. What's this? Set checkpoint. Well, I mean, this is... I think that this is supposed to be the first level, isn't it? But where does this go? Makes you jump high? Wait, is there something up here? Fly dash. Wait, what? Tap to do an air dash that has quick horizontal speed. Maybe not like that, but that's fine. Let me go back to the actual levels. Well, there is also a shop. A protective guardian defense against a lethal hit and will recharge over time. Your second double jump gets a huge boost, but can no longer be cancelled until grounded. What does that mean? I don't know what that means. Hold the glide dash button while in human form to charge a powerful glide dash diagonally upwards. I feel like I'm too dumb to understand this power-up. Rollout triggers immediately but no longer hopes for extra height. Your super sham dribble launches you forward with increased momentum. Your spin briefly lifts you upwards when held. See, this one seems useful, and I actually understand it. You know? That's cool. About the rest, I don't know, but that one seems useful. But yeah, give it to me. What is this? That's supposed to be like a car? These are some very weird cars. Is that how cars are gonna look in the future? If that's the case, I would prefer if we didn't go to the future. It doesn't seem like you can even use this. Alright. See, like... I don't know what's the point of those candies. It just seems weird. The way you just have to wait to get them all. Oh, this thing changes when you jump. I just realized that this game also has the Super Mario 64 triple jump. On the third consecutive jump, you go higher. I was initially comparing this against Super Mario 64 as a show, but it does seem to take from it. Well, maybe you could make the argument that every game takes from Super Mario 64. I'm just kidding. That's a game that I should play. At least that's a game that I'm gonna be playing for a while. It's a long game. Oh, there are more candies down there. Give it to me. I can't see. Wait. But I'm dead now. Did I just get scammed? Or can I actually recover in those platforms? Well, not with that amount of jumps. Wait, will this be the... Yeah, that's the right amount of jumps. Got it. That also reminded me that I need to set up a checkpoint, well, most likely here. I should set it here. Boom. Okay. I wonder why there is no run button. I know that you have the spinning ball, but I will assume that you could... You know. Anything up there? No. I gotta remember the vinyl. I'm looking for the vinyl more than anything else. Well, for candies too. The perspective should change. Now we're in 2D. We are 2D in a 2D environment. Wait, what's... Oh, there is a platform. Oh, there is the vinyl. Nice. Well, at least so far I'm not having... troubles finding these things. So that's cool. At the same time, I look at the gold medals of these levels, and I don't see any way I can get them. It just seems way too hard to get gold. Yeah, come on, that's what I say. I couldn't possibly know that was gonna be there. Alright. nice if you could look at the medals under. Well, not actually there. Probably should set a checkpoint after I'm done champing here. But like, you know that there are a lot of games that that feature medals, and they usually let you know how you get to that medal. It would be cool if you could do that here, because I think that a lot of these levels, I just wouldn't know how to even get the medals. Because I can see how you will go fast in a straight line. But how will you go fast in a in places like this? Really? Is there anything down there? Doesn't look like it, right? And nothing in the middle either. Uh-oh. And we have... Really, these things are cheating. They are spinning in a 3D perspective. Well, technically I can also move in a 3D perspective here, but... Not very easily. The perspective is over here, though. I'm a very big fan. There are a lot of shadows. Wait, what's producing this shadow? Oh, that thing there. The place that we just been into. Like, for example, this candy here. I feel like I will just remove it. Because getting to it is just a little bit of a pain in the ass. I mean, it's not hard. But it's just like... Oh, I didn't set any checkpoint. Oh, I'm an idiot. I should have set a checkpoint after that zone. I keep forgetting about the checkpoints. I'm just not used to set my own checkpoints, dude. It's just something that I think there was one game that I played before that had settable checkpoints, but I can't remember which one. What game was it? I wish I could remember. I remember playing one game like that. And I made the same mistake twice. Fuck, that's so frustrating. Well, next time I'm definitely gonna remember setting the checkpoint, but... Damn it. Would be nice if the game reminded you, like, in the first levels. But that was some sort of tutorial. The game is not gonna remind you now. But these things are so easy to fall from. Alright. I mean, I could set a checkpoint here. They are infinite. They don't get worn out. Unlike the game I'm thinking about. The game I'm thinking about, I remember the checkpoints disappearing. Well, disappearing. Being a resource. Can you remember if it's a game that I played or not? Was it a game that I played? Maybe. Well, that I played on stream, I mean. Yeah, I wish I could remember, but I don't. I also remember being super stingy with the checkpoints in whatever game that was. If only I could remember which game that was. It's gonna be impossible. That it's gonna be impossible to remember that. cannot make it there. And I lost my chance. It's okay. Dude, these platforms are messing me up. It's like I'm getting stuck in the edge. More candies here. Well, I guess you can call a game that has checkpoints that you can set will be a lot of survival horror games in the PS1 era. Usually you will set a save point. You will just set a save point in a save room. Oh, I'm dead. Oops. Hey, you will set a save point on a save room, but it usually costed you something. I think that in the Resident Evil games it's ink. What it costs you. Okay, this one seems to be hard. Need to do something about that. Well, I'm glad I set this checkpoint here. Yeah, this doesn't seem very easy. Especially if you want to get those damn candies. I mean, that's the issue. I think that if you want to get through this normally, that works. Alright. Careful with the spikes. And now, up there. Okay, only four of these remain. Wait a second, don't tell me that I miss one. Please tell me the last one is here. Wait, it's not here. Fuck. I mean, I can teleport around, but which one did I miss? Damn, I don't believe it. I miss one. Yeah, God knows where it's gonna be. There are so many places. Wait a second. You can only teleport between... Oh, I get it. If you set a checkpoint, you can't teleport between checkpoints. You can only teleport between the first and the last one. Well, the first checkpoint, which is the beginning of the level. So, might as well not even count as a checkpoint. And this is what... This was one of my fears. What if I reach the end of the level and I'm missing one? Oh, and it's here. Okay, never mind. See? No problem. Now I can reset to flag. Okay, nice. Very cool. Well, I got lucky there. Could have been a lot worse. It was in like the middle of the level. Right. Hey, that's the one thing that always scares me when I try to collect everything in a level. It's that... It's rough. You miss one thing, makes it feel like you did everything for no reason. So, since I'm collecting all these candies, something that I should probably do is use them. They are used as currency to buy upgrades. Just that I don't... Oh! There is things up there. Just that some upgrades I didn't understood them very well. And it seems that not every upgrade is a straight upgrade. Some of them are things that come with a disadvantage. Well, you can still call them upgrades. Uh-oh. We're going fast. Oh, it just stops there. Is there something above the train? Doesn't look like it. No, in fact, it is inside the train. Hello. Okay, so I think that that was supposed to be my enemy in the previous game. I mean, for what I've seen in the reviews, I know that the Steam reviews are probably not the best source of opinion of a game, but the way that the Steam reviews talk about the previous game, it made them seem that the game was very bloated. Which is kind of the opposite of this game. This game is very short. Cute? I know. How is it going, Yannick? I wouldn't be surprised if this character was based on Satania, or whatever you pronounce that name. You know that girl from that anime, Gabriel's Dropout. I have a feeling that it's based on that character. Because we already know that the developers are weebs, so that's definitely within the realm of possibilities. You know? Wait, what's the right way? Because there are trains there. Then there's also that thing there. Or are both the right ways? What's even in here? I got a chair, I can sit. Pretty nice, but... Oh. I've been ill. Oh, that'd kill me? Really? So this miss kills you. And this demon doesn't really have... Look, I know that demons usually are portrayed as having a lot of weaknesses, but come on. You are weak to water, to spikes, to poison. I mean, that would be normal if you were a normal person, but you're a demon. You're supposed to be above those things. You love that anime? Well, I didn't watch it. But for some reason, that character is super popular. I don't even know what the anime is about. I mean, it's probably slice of life or what it looks like, but I don't know what it is about. Though, judging by the name, I will assume that it's about heaven and hell or some shit like that. Wait, is this? Oh, this is going down. I just realized. It's gonna go back up. It goes back up at a very, very slow pace, though. Like, goddamn, that's slow. Why is everything in this game so slow? Satanicha McDowell? Well, I don't know her name. But yeah, whatever her name is, yeah, that girl. I wouldn't be surprised if this character was based on that. I mean, she's even a redhead. You know? Well, then again, making a demon having hair, the hair being red is a very common choice, I guess. You know that red is usually the color of hell and all that shit. So I guess that makes sense, but my head canon is that the developers base this character on that character. That's my fan fiction. But as I say, the developers are weebs. So knowing that, they most likely did that. There's nothing that I'm missing there, right? doesn't look like it. Wait, is that a... That seems like that's a shortcut to make this faster, because that seems like a bouncer. Oh, really? I didn't even notice that hurt you. You got a raise in your shop? Nice. Wait, did you have a shop? I didn't remember that. My bad. What was your shop? I didn't remember that you had a shop. But hey, congratulations. Are you also a web developer? Angular and Spring. Yeah, because I remember that Hypami and Blue are web developers, but I didn't remember you being a web developer. Well, welcome to the party. But yeah. I guess nowadays everyone is a web developer. I also work with Angular and Spring. It's just that the Angular I work with is Angular.js. A little bit older. But hey, I'm an expert at Angular.js. What can I say? That's obviously an exaggeration, but yeah. I'm very comfortable with Angular.js. I mean, it's pretty much the first the first framework I use, and basically I put in my curriculum Angular.js, and when the company that hired me saw that, was like, okay, this is the one. What you mean imagine? I don't need to imagine it. I do it every day. Well, every weekday. Yeah, come on, bro. What's wrong with Angular.js? Oh, I fucked that up. No, that's fine. That's fine. Don't worry. I should go fast here. I should have put a checkpoint. That I, again, forgot. Though at the same time, I'm not sure if I have all of the required candies. But since that place seems like it could take some time, not to mention scaling that tower again takes some time, I probably should set a checkpoint there. Nice wheel, thanks. Oh, that's not gonna work. I'm not fast enough. Yeah. Damn it. Okay, that should work though. Will it work? Yeah. Oh, it did work. Nice. Oh yeah. Oh, and also Spring. I'm using Spring MVC. There was a project that used Spring Boot, but I'm using the old version of Spring. We like using obsolete software. Okay, so I miss something. I wonder where. But for the fact that there are three remaining, what I miss is pretty clearly a crystal. It's just that good luck finding that. So I could teleport at the beginning of the level. I mean, this level is not really that long in terms of the distance you go. I mean, it's long because you need to do a bunch of shit, but... Wait, I need to find a crystal. There is a crystal somewhere. It needs to be found. Yeah, if you see a crystal, let me know. Where is the... Oof, I almost got fucked. Where is the remaining crystal? Maybe it was at the end and I didn't see it, but... Didn't seem like there was a crystal at the end. Maybe it was in this place. I don't think it was. I mean, this is where the vinyl was, but you can keep going forward. Well, not to mention, did I go up here? There's nothing there. Well, not now at least. But yeah, this is the place that is pretty much a shortcut. Well, a shortcut that I don't know how you're supposed to move into. Yeah, that didn't seem to work that well. But then, I need a crystal. Where is the crystal? Where did I miss it? Well, from here I should be able to see it more easily, I guess. Well, with all the bloom and shit, maybe not more easily. She has a full animation, that's pretty funny. Where could Mr. Crystal be? Oh, it's not a crystal, it's just these three little shits up here. Damn it. Moving on. Cheeky little shits. Alright, let's go back to the... to the finish. That's the second time I get hit by that, come on. It's not even in the way. Well, I mean, it's technically in the way. I mean that it's not in the middle. Nice. Got it. Beautiful. Alright. I think that's the last level, yeah, of Neon City. That's how this thing is called. I can get more of these mods. Let's see. A protective guardian defense against a little hit. I mean, I could get that. But I don't think that's that useful. Rollout triggers immediately but no longer hopes for extra height. Do I really care about the hope for extra height? I'm not sure. Oh wait, I didn't even equip this. How do you... oh, there you go. That's how you equip them. Oh wait! I get it! You can only have one equip at a time. Interesting. Well, in that case, I prefer having this one. I didn't know that, but you can buy them all, of course. Alright. So this is supposed to be a new world. Know what it is about. Like ice? Don't tell me there are ice physics, please. That will be a problem. Well, there is a snow. What do you have to say? This doesn't... okay, I can see, and never mind, it does look like a paintbrush. Ice to meet you. And I wish I was good at puns, but I'm not. And again, I kinda tend to have a little bit of rejection against puns, but yeah, I'm not good at them. Well, that's because I'm an ESL. Well, I guess I might be good at Spanish puns. What's the point? You need to learn the Sino ways. You know, I like the way that... well, at least the Japanese dub pronounces Sino. They kind of pronounce it Seno. Seno, like, you know, the guy from Dragon Ball Super. Senosama. And I'm really curious to see where the Dragon Ball Super anime is gonna go next. I want to see how everything goes to shit even more. Do you see that there is a Binil? I mean, there is a Binil in all of these places. You say that it's in this mountain. No matter how much you go around it, you cannot find it. Isn't it all the way up there, maybe? Can I even go up there? Doesn't look like it. Well, let me put a checkpoint before I get fucked. Oh, I can actually go up here. I'm not sure if there is supposed to be anything in there. Is there? I mean, the problem is that you bounce there, no matter what happens. Doesn't even seem like you're allowed to go higher than that. Okay, now you can roll. Come on. We'll roll no issues last time. Alright, maybe you... Oh, there it is. It's that one. Stop bouncing! No, damn it. You suck of shit. Yeah, that's what I tell you, come on. It was as simple as not bouncing. Where is your grip? Wait a second. You didn't even need to do all that shit. It's here. Is this Kappa blind or what? It's right there, you stupid fuck. You just need to look around a little bit. Damn. What a blind... Doesn't he even wear glasses? Hey, something tells me that your glasses ain't working. You know... Your glasses might need an upgrade. I was like, I need to go all around it because it's gonna be hard to find, but no. No, what's gonna be hard is to deal with this mountain in general. Because this place does have ice physics. Or at least something very similar to it. So here, you can actually climb back or not. At some point, it seems that you should bounce. And like, right there, it just bounces me for some reason. I guess in that case, it should be a reset. I don't mind. I like how when you die by a reset instead of dying because you got hit. Like, she has a smug face. It's pretty funny. I meant to die. I'm not sure. Wait, is this supposed to be the secret? No, you keep going there. The big glasses he like instead of the meta glasses. Damn, you're always gonna tease me about that, aren't you? Well, that reminds me, did you do the event? Hyperbloom worked well, yet again, to nobody's surprise. Oh, yeah. Very nice. Let me try. In fact, I'm pretty sure that you can pick anything that is not a Hyperbloom, and as long as it deals a little bit of damage, you can win that one. Oh, these are sad faces, I just realized. Why are they sad? Are they sad because Hyperbloom is meta? Yeah, I can sympathize with that. What happens when it's all smiles? What's gonna happen? Wait, aren't those all smiles, or did I miss? Oh, this one. Got it. And what's this? Oh, it's a fan. goes into a little crystal. I should probably put a checkpoint here. Place it here. See, the thing is that here I think it's faster. Instead of doing what I'm doing now, it's just faster to stay in a platform and wait until you automatically pick up all of the candies. It really feels like that. I just feel like it's a weird choice that that you need to wait for this. It would just be better if they should stay in place. Instead of flying like that for no reason. Right. Oh, not to mention that these platforms are slippery. At least you can kind of reset that by doing a regular jump. Okay, thankfully I did get all the candies because can tell that, yeah, the last three are gonna be here. There you go. Easy. Nice. Okay. That went well. So far, my collectionist reactions are going well. That's cool. I guess over the past years, I gotten better at being a collectionist. In video games, I mean. And by that, I don't mean collecting video games. I mean collecting things in video games. I still don't like doing it, though. But I definitely have gotten better at it. That... Wait, there is something here. Is the Beano? Well, that's pretty cool. We have the Beano right at the beginning. And we don't need to worry about that for the rest of the stage. Pretty nice. Cooks. So I think I'm actually supposed to go here. I don't think I miss any candy, right? No, don't seem to be any candy up there. No. Careful. The way these things scream is a little bit sad. Then again, I'm a demon, supposed to be bad and evil and all of that. Oh, I should set a checkpoint here. Before I get bullshitted like that. See? The game definitely lets you know that you want to set checkpoints. Something that at first it might be hard to remember, but then it really becomes a second nature. But then again, it's not like the game is too long, but that's fine. I didn't mean to jump there. I just got too close. I shouldn't have. Oh, it's interesting that theoretically a lot of these levels can be beaten super fast. Like, a lot of these gold medals that I'm seeing are like 2 minutes or less. You can actually beat these levels surprisingly fast. Kinda curious to try that. I don't think I will be able to be that fast. Like, I might have gotten better at being a collectionist, but I don't think I gotten better at being faster. Oh, also, even if you try, like, you can move a little bit back and forth, but there is an invisible wall that keeps you from moving out of this 2D bounds. Right, I should probably save here. Save. I mean, set a checkpoint. Oh, this thing. Nice. Is there something there? No. Sometimes I confuse the particles in the air with candies. They are just particles. I don't know, particles of what though? Look like leaves. Why will there be leaves here in the first place? Okay. Now what? Should I go down? Well, I mean, I could go up. There doesn't seem to be anything up there, so I think I need to go down. That scream is funny. Right. This level, judging by the amount of candies I have right now, seems pretty easy. I don't know if I have all of them. Let's see. Oh, I might be missing one. Which kinda sucks. Oh. No, I'm not missing any, actually. Wait, before I do anything stupid, since I know that I have all of them, just put this checkpoint here. No need to risk it unnecessarily. I don't know how to get to that. Oh, you can... I didn't know that you could wall jump that. It had like a cylinder shape. I assume you couldn't. You can. That one seems hard. And the problem here is that the risk... For some reason, this thing is not making me go higher. Even though I have that modifier, that wouldn't work. Yeah, the scream is funny, but what's not funny is this platform. Well, maybe I could go up here, and from here I could jump there. Or not. How do I get there? Well, I mean, I could technically get there by falling from above. Or maybe not, actually. Well, actually, it was just a simple double jump. Yeah, this level was pretty easy. Like, I think that so far this being the easiest level in the game. Or at least the shortest. I don't know if easiest. But I guess here length probably equals difficulty. Alright. I wonder if this is gonna be the last level. Well, it's literally called Neon Splash, which is, you know, the title drop. So yeah, I will assume it is. Let me just buy the remaining ones. Well, the remaining ones, the ones that I can buy. And to buy this one, I will only need 80 more. So that means that I have 80 candies that I can shove up my ass. Oh, I didn't have this one equipped. That's why I couldn't go up there. I'm pretty sure I did equip it. The game is cheating on me. That's why I couldn't get that one that easily. But like that previous candy, I mean. unless that neon splash level at the end is doesn't have any candies, but I think it does. I think it had the icon. Fuck. What I also want to see is what the remix version of the levels is. Because every vinyl you pick up has precisely that functionality that you're supposed to, you know. You unlock a remix level. Yeah, I don't know what those remix levels are for. I mean, they are for playing, that much is correct, but I mean, aside from that, what do they offer differently? What the hell is that sound? Oh! Alright, so this thing is gonna... it's gonna sink. Is that how it is? Is my character is too fat, or what's the issue? This is not the first structure that I step into and I sink into the ground. Am I just too fat? Well, then again, with all the candies that this girl eats, it's no wonder, but... I'm dead. Well, surprisingly not yet. Oh, because I think that that might have been the end of the line. So I don't know if I miss anything, because I could barely see. This thing was going down. I did miss a couple things. I hope I didn't... oh, I did miss even some candies here. I cannot even collect them. What I hope is that I don't miss a vinyl. Because you don't really have time to look at it. Well, I mean, look for it. Oh. Can I even set... no, but that's the thing. You cannot really set a checkpoint anywhere here. We'll assume that you also cannot set a checkpoint in this place when it starts crumbling. Basically, you need to do it from the beginning. I mean, it's not like it's that big of a deal, but... want to properly explore this place? Well, then again, I don't think there's that much to explore in the first place. At least I pick up that candy. But this place seems like the biggest difficulty is not dying by the water. I guess I could put a checkpoint here. I mean, it's not like it makes that big of a difference, but better than nothing. Try to do it as fast as you can. As you can't. Yeah. As fast as you can. Not can't. That would be weird. Okay, what's this? Oh, that's the vinyl. This I got that. Wait, is the water gonna reach up here? Oh, I got an achievement find. Oh, the water does reach here. Am I fine though? I think I am fine. Alright. Yeah, no worries. Hopefully I also pick up all the candies. Oh, I still cannot set a checkpoint. Wait, what's this? Is that fire? Oh, I'm going up now. Well, don't tell me that. I think that that basically, like, now you can explore the whole thing. Should have known. So more than that, like, I feel like this is gonna kill me. Oh, it's a teleport. That's a weird looking teleport. That looks like fire. But then again, being a demon, I shouldn't die with fire. This challenge is made for hyper carries? What do you mean? I was able to do it with hyper bloom. What you mean? I mean, I know that the bonus might be, might have that idea in mind, but you can choose hyper bloom. Oh, I didn't know that that ray frees you.
Moving on.
Probably should reset. Hey, come on, bro. Just hyper bloom and you're gonna be fine. Like, with almost all the content in the game, just hyper bloom, bro. Can even get the electric guys with that. Hyper Bloom doesn't care about that. Alright, now what? What is this? Oh, this goes up. Goes up while spinning. Interesting combination. Alright. Wait, how do I get those? They are in the middle, aren't they? Nice, I got them. I should set a checkpoint here. Because a lot of these candies seem very hard to get. No, come on! Well, not just the candies, but actually, you know, like, actually getting to the other side doesn't seem that easy. These platforms work in weird ways. Okay, now I have to worry about these candies. They are very hard to get. Oh. Wow, alright. Wait, do these things bounce you? Oh, I see. In that case, I shouldn't worry about falling. Well, I mean, I should worry about falling regardless, but I mean that I shouldn't worry about slipping into the platform. That's another teleport. That's a couple of crystals. You have it? Okay. Go into the teleport. Oop. Okay. I should definitely set a flag here. You know that this part reminds me of a Super Mario Galaxy 2 level.
Moving on.
Like this whole spinning thing. That's another game that I should play on stream. That game is very good. Okay, we need to go a little bit faster than this. I might possibly need to use the spin dash here. I also cannot really take shortcuts, because if I do, I miss out on the candies. Alright, that works. Lot of this. Ah, come on. Damn, that's such a pain in the ass. Well, I guess here I could skip some of this. As long as I am there for, like, the last ones. But it seems that it's gonna be harder to do it that way. What happens if I spin here, though? That doesn't seem like a good idea. Because I don't think I will be able to jump in these gaps. Wait, what? Why did that become purple? Maybe some reflection thing? Perhaps? This is the place I die. Pretty easy to die there. Wait, is that the Lucy or whatever her name was? Can I talk to her? Doesn't look like it. She's just spinning there. She just feels like spinning. Okay, and I got the achievement for... That turf is toast. I got the achievement for getting all the candies. So at least we don't have to worry about that. And here there is a final level. Well, let me buy all the last one of this. Alright. I got an achievement also for buying all the shit. And this is the last level. It doesn't have any collectible. But you are meant to go fast. Oh, is this gonna be like a very fast level?
Hi, Bibzy.
Hey, I saw you in the previous level. I didn't even see those as spikes. Okay, so I don't think I can go very fast here.
Oh.
I guess this is Lucy just helping me out. Yeah, I don't know if you could do this too fast. Because you're supposed to wait for Lucy to put everything that you need. Probably should set a checkpoint. Wait, what? Oh. Wait, but I'm supposed to avoid the paint here. Aren't you supposed to help me? What's wrong with you? Okay. Wait, these things are targeting me. Don't get crushed. I'm not really worried about getting crushed. I probably should though. I'm more worried about these things targeting me. Come on! I couldn't see that.
Oh.
Damn. That place is gonna be a real issue. I should set a checkpoint. Wait, that place seems like a problem.
Oh.
Okay, you are not supposed to do that. But then, like, at the end of that, it really makes you want to jump out like that. Surprised that that's what you're not supposed to do. I'm also surprised why this doesn't always work. A little bit weird. She also is not even trying to paint this thing like she did last time, so I'm also not sure about that. Whatever. But yeah, this place is a problem because it's basically a survival. You have to survive these turrets while at the same time you go up these platforms. It's pretty hard to see the platforms. Well, it's more like it's pretty hard to see the platforms and the bullets at the same time. And I got killed by the same thing. But dude, if I just wait there, I'm gonna get killed. Like, if I just wait in the middle, the turrets are gonna shoot me down. You know? Then again, keep in mind that this is... Wait, let me put a checkpoint here. Before I forget. So, couldn't you... No, you need to land here so she... She spawns those things. Wonder if there is a way to even skip this place. There might be. I thought these were Tetriminos, but they aren't. Some of them are only three. Finally got to the top.
Hi, Bildi.
What am I looking at? I know what I'm looking at, but I think I'm just gonna put the checkpoint there. No, it was just a regular section. Is that the end? Well, if I don't die a single time and this is the end... No, it's not the end. They got too cocky.
What?
Wait, set a checkpoint, god damn it. Keep forgetting. Are you trying to help or are you trying to kill me? I can't really tell. Quite honestly. That... Fuck.
Moving on.
Yeah, it's like you're switching the properties of all the platforms constantly. I'm not even sure what I'm bouncing on. Well, bouncing or landing, it depends. Right, go to the other side. No. Wait. I think that getting the gold medal in a level like this will be a little bit hard. Will be quite hard to do it. Oh, you're supposed to avoid the pain. Wait, so the pain doesn't kill you. It just covers your vision. Right. But yeah, I don't think I can get the gold medal in a level like this. Or any medal for that matter. Okay. And now what?
Hi, Bibi.
You're gonna see the credits? Deal with the grouping not being... Oh, okay. Well, congrats. There's only one more to go. Of those challenges. We're back at the normal world. You are not done yet, Tim. Unlock all the Remets levels, I have them all. Collect all the suites, I already did it. Beat all the trophies. I didn't do that, but I'm pretty sure I cannot do that. Yeah, but let me try the Remets levels. So the Remets levels don't have collectibles, but they are harder. Well, the thing is that here, without the collectibles, it's like trying to do them fast will be a problem. Attack speed is funny. Attack speed is cool. Yeah, I know that I'm not double. See, that's the thing. 100. Wait a second. Give me. And I'm. I wasn't even going where I was supposed to go. So the remix levels, it's not like they just make the level harder, but they also change the way it works completely. Okay, gotcha. But yeah. Wait, and I'm fucking up already. Problem is that you appear in this level and you look there. Yeah, I know there is an arrow here, but why don't you just point where you need to point? Then it'd be easier. You want me to roll here? That didn't go very well. I think I'm not supposed to jump though. Wait, and for some reason. See, but that's the thing. Every time I die. That's something you can change in the menu, but. Every time I die, it doesn't reset the timer even if it's the first checkpoint. That's a little bit messed up. Or maybe you are supposed to jump there. Yeah, the roll is super fast. If you want to do these levels fast, you kinda need to do that. But wait, problem is that I don't know if that's a thing that I want to do, because you have an option in gameplay that streamer name. No, I don't wanna do that. But no, there is, yeah, this dead restart. Restart, sorry. But that's the problem. I don't want the level to always restart from the beginning. What I want is, like, if I haven't set a checkpoint, the timer to restart on the beginning. And I don't think that you can do that, unfortunately. But whatever. Not like I expect to get these gold medals at all. As I say before, I'm not a speedrunner. I think that I'm just casually gonna beat these levels. Just a casual gamer after all. Oh shit. I can't see shit! Okay, that worked. Surprisingly. You know, considering that you have pretty much infinite checkpoints, I think levels like this that don't have collectibles, the only challenge is pretty much to do it fast. It's just playing the level to the end. I don't think that's particularly hard to do. Like, if you can just set infinite checkpoints, eventually you're gonna beat it, you know? Well, I didn't know that hurt you. Come on, that looked like a decoration. Are you kidding me? That just looked like a decoration, but it wasn't a decoration. I got baited. This is the end. Well, without restarting that match at the beginning, I could have probably gotten like the bronze medal or something. Probably. I want to see the leaderboards. So 26 seconds. Wait, why are... Wait a second. You can use two of those things? Because, okay. Because they are different equipables. Like, you can equip a shirt and a haircut, or, well, a hair thingy. I don't know, this one? I still don't understand the other ones too much. So I think that I'm gonna keep this. Though the green hair looks a little bit weird. That's fine. Not to mention that it's a little bit useless if I die immediately. Isn't there a way to restart the level? Oh yeah, where it says retry. And maybe that's where you restarted. I'm not sure if you're supposed to use the rollout here. Well, yeah, you're definitely supposed to. Just that it's a little bit hard to make use of. Also here, I'm assuming. I mean, that was pretty slow, but don't worry about it. Still got it. On. Probably a way to skip that or something. Maybe. The placement of those conveyor belts is a little bit weird, I feel. It's not like they are a very heavy obstacle. I'm gonna put a checkpoint just in case. I'm supposed to go up there, right? I think I am. Probably could have taken a shortcut from there, but wasn't very confident. That's most likely how it would have worked. Ah, fuck me. No. Still survive, though. Wait, am I really supposed to do that? Actually, I'm not sure, because in the original level, you were not supposed to go up. Like, you basically come from above. But right there, there was an arrow pointing upwards. So, are you? I'm pretty sure I can go from here. Right? Yeah, we can just be here. Oh, damn it. Spike almost killed me. The only way to go up is by using this. Alright. Yeah, you are supposed to be here. Shame that I got disoriented a little bit. Not like I would have gotten the gold anyways. But maybe I could have gotten the bronze. Or not. The medals seem a little bit hard to do. Now I'm just gonna be happy with beating these levels. Yeah, they are definitely not easy. Oh, the game still encourages me. It says you nailed it. Yeah, you're very good, bro. In reality, you fucking suck, but nah, you got it. Alright. Yeah, that's fine. I like when games give me... encourage me, right? I meant to say give me encouragement. Yeah, whatever, English is hard. Yeah, you are a winner. You are winner. That reminds me that I want to play... I've been saying this for some time, but... I want to play more arcade racing games. I mean, you know that I... Wait, this is not the right way to go. Oops. Wait, let me restart. I was about to say... Yeah, no, not big rigs particularly. But no, it's like, the other day I saw a WEVM, a little video, to make it easier, of a game that looked like a PS2 game, I think. It was about, you know, some car driving in the night streets. And it looked pretty cool. I mean, I don't know if the game is any good, but at least that video made it look cool. We'll be getting baited though, but yeah, it looked pretty nice. So I kind of want to play something like that, but I think the issue is knowing. Know what they say, that knowing is half the battle, and it indeed is half the battle. Maybe even more than half. Come on, well, I'm glad that I set the checkpoint at least. Yeah. Dude! What's wrong with that platform? Is it further than what I think it is? I guess it is further. It's not like it's... Oh, I'm dead. Oh, never mind, that actually lasted for quite a long time. But yeah. I really like arcade racing games, what can I say? They are one of those things that are just very good. But I could also try hard F-Zero Eds and F-Zero Sheeds. Those games are hard. Oh, you're supposed to go below. I might be dead. Wait, I survived that? Alright, hey. Don't mind me. I don't know how that happened, but that was pretty funny. Well, the thing is that thing is gonna stop above, and I probably won't be able to get to the top platform anyways, but... It would be nice if I could just bug it, but yeah, no, it's probably gonna stop at some point. I won't be able to do shit. Ah, oh, damn it. No, come on. What a pain in the ass. I mean, at this point, it's better to reset because if it doesn't work... Though I probably should have set up a checkpoint. I'm a little bit dumb. I should have set up a checkpoint. To that place. I mean the checkpoint, I don't think it cares about the state of things. Even if that the laser is already up, it's not gonna remember that. That was a little bit dumb on me. At least something that it's sure and that I shouldn't worry about at all is the that I'm not gonna get the medals at all. Really? Wait, I didn't set a checkpoint, did I? Did I forget? I have a feeling that I forgot. I can't see shit, Mr. Game. Oh, come on! That's so dirty. Hey, I forgot about the checkpoint. Also, you know that this game, when you activate V-Sync, it gives you a warning. It says that it might cause some problems with streaming software. Like, this is looking fine on stream, right? Like, the V-Sync is not screwing anything up, right? Well, I mean, it's a little bit too late to ask now, but... Just wanted to know. Because, yeah. It's quite a little detail. Too much input lag. I don't think that's related with streaming software, mister. Oh, that's the reason why I survive. I survive because I tank a hit. Interesting. But I gotta assume that everything went well. That's good. For some reason, I mean, I don't know how BSync will cause problem with streaming software. I can understand the argument of the input lag, but the streaming software, why would BSync get in the way of that? I mean, I know that I don't understand the technical aspect of BSync very well, but I don't think that will be something that get in the way. Would it? What I do know is that when it comes to streaming software, some games don't like when you capture in game capture mode. They are not a fan of that. Champ King, I think, is one of them. They want you to capture in window mode. It's whatever. It happens. Alright. Now on to the finish line. Okay. At least I can kinda say that these levels are relatively hard to beat, even having like infinite checkpoints, you know? Like, they are definitely not super easy. I guess there is that. I can definitely tell you is that, well, at least not now. Like, maybe someday I wake up and I'm like them. I really, really want to beat all of this game's levels with getting the gold medal, right? But I'm definitely not gonna do that today, that's for sure. But yeah, it seems that that's something that is pretty hard. Like, you really need to master the way the game works. If you don't, there is just no way. You are just done for. Nice. I'm also pretty curious what the game says that... what the game says that I'm gonna get at 100%. Because it says that maybe you will get something. But see, the game said maybe. Wait, I should put a checkpoint here. Okay, the game saying maybe... Like, what guarantee do you give me? That's like, I don't know, saying the... you know, you go to a grocery store and you want to buy bread. You tell the cashier, like, here. Like, you give it the money. Then it maybe will give you the bread if you give them money. Maybe. If they feel like it. If the cashier woke up in a good mood, it will give it to you. Hey, I don't know. What could you possibly get here? What kind of reward could this game give you at 100%? I will assume it will have to be something cheesy like a 100% completion picture. Yeah, bread gacha. Yeah, but I don't know. You know what they... No, come on! What a... I should make it, though. Yeah, this upgrade is fantastic. The upgrade that lets your spin go higher, it's the best upgrade in the game. There is no wonder why so many have this up, well, so many. The few that I've seen that have upgrades have this one on the leaderboards. It's definitely no wonder. Yeah, I'm really curious to see what the 100% reward is, but I gotta tell you that not curious enough to actually put the effort that you need. Oh shit, have a foot race? It needs to be done in 30 seconds. Ouch. did I pass? I don't think I passed. But yeah. What I gotta say is that I'm thankful that I didn't go for the first game, because the first game, the one that came before this one, seems to have a lot of combat. I cannot really imagine myself doing combat with this type of physics. I don't think it will sit well with me. You know? I think that will be hard to do. Probably. Yeah, I think that going for this game was the right choice. Well, not to mention that this game is also cheaper than the first game. I will have to say that it was the right idea. Moving on. So I'm not even sure what you get by finishing those races. Like, do this platform show up and they weren't here before or what? I should set a checkpoint here. Okay, this thing only... It's like the Mario Kart squid. If you get hit by it, that's fine. But though in Mario Kart, just by using a mushroom or a booster, it's enough to get rid of it. But even when you have it, it's usually not a problem. Unless it's like a very specific place that being able to look is super important. That usually doesn't tend to happen. Alright. Put the checkpoint here. Right, that'll work. I fucked up. No, I mean, they are gonna respawn. But I actually fooled them. I can't believe how much I fucked up there. Like, I did everything wrong. Everything that was possible to do wrong, I did it wrong. Absolutely everything was wrong. Nice. I like when that happens. Just that... one thing that I don't get used to in this game is that the wall jump doesn't work the moment you do a double jump. That's something that I'm not... Well, I mean, I'm not used to having two double jumps either, but yeah. I think it's harder to get used to the fact that... to the way wall champs work. Especially because you don't really need to use wall champs most of the times. They are not something that you use very frequently. I probably could have gotten the bronze medal if I hadn't died. I wonder when I'm even gonna get a single medal. Because it's not a matter that I didn't get the gold medals, which yes, I didn't. But I didn't even get a bronze medal. Even a miserable bronze medal, I haven't gotten it. That's very sad. Okay. Don't worry, we can tank that. Oh, you're supposed to go here. Okay. And this is ice. No. Well, I don't know how I'm still alive. I'll take it. Huh. Pretty original. Okay. That's the first time that you use the spin for something other than, well, flying. Right? I'm assuming that I'm not supposed to step on those things. Oof. Alright. I'm still alive. Thanks to a pure miracle. I should probably get a checkpoint. That went well. That went very, very well. Maybe this might be the level where I get one medal. Maybe it will be my first medal in the whole game. Well, medals. They are trophies, but it's the same concept. And definitely have to use this here. Wait, are you supposed to use the wheel here? I don't think so. Oh, that looks pretty cool. Okay, thankfully we can tank ahead. That's also an upgrade that is super important. And even a silver! I can't believe it, I got a silver medal. Unbelievable. A shame that I couldn't get the gold one. But yeah. Got a silver medal. The first medal ever. I am speechless. Oh wow, this looks very purple. What the hell? Look at this. This almost hurts my eyes with how purple it is. Isn't this a little bit too purple? Damn. You know that I heard that most people that are colorblind cannot see purple. There are different types of colorblindness, if that's a word. But yeah, apparently most of them have the purple as something that they cannot properly see. This wouldn't look very good for someone that is colorblind. Maybe. I don't know. Not an expert. Oh, I should have set a checkpoint. God damn it. It's okay. I'm gonna set it here. Boom. Glorious cherry blossomed. I don't think this is even cherry blossom. These are just neon particles. Nice, good tank. Gorgeous neon particles. Wait, am I supposed to wall champ here? Oh, at least... Okay, see here? You can actually wall jump after a... Wait, what did I... Oh, there you go. But like, here you can actually... Well, wall jump. You're not really jumping, you're just digging to the wall. Yeah, you can do that regardless. Well, that's the exit. They only got bronze. But hey, at least it was a medal. But yeah, the gold is something that... That will be very hard to get. I will say almost impossible. I kind of want to try in the regular levels, but I don't think that I can even get them in the regular levels. It's just way too hard. It's a very hard thing. Fuck me. Can you stop switching, mister? Wait, isn't this... Oh, okay. So this is where the Benil was. Pretty interesting. Wait, oh, you're supposed to go here. Yeah. And what I still cannot believe is that... Remember that the game... Well, speaking of Neon... That the game called Neon White... That was about a bunch of criminals that were in heaven. And what a stoner ass game, but something that I remember about that game is that I tried harder like the medals a lot. And I think I got all of the not super hard medals. That was really something. I played that game for like 6 streams to get all of that. Well, at the same time, it was a gift. Which, speaking of gift, I still have to play Deus Ex that Yannick gifted to me. Still haven't played that game. As I say, that's a game that I won't play until I play Half-Life. I have to first play the Half-Life games, and then I will unlock that game to be played, you know? Oh, careful. Fox! Was pretty far. At least the checkpoint was right here. See, I shouldn't double jump out of that. If I double jump out of that, I'm dead. I should, instead of trying to correct a bad jump, I should just jump well. Yeah, that's the issue. It makes you jump in the middle of a corner, which inevitably means that you're gonna slide out, you know. I mean, you just have to line it up. You have to line it up right before the jump. Jesus. It's easier said than done, as you can tell. God damn it. Whatever. Easier said than done, for sure. Right. Well, because there's also the danger of even oversteering. You oversteer, and what are you gonna do? Oof. That was close. Thankfully I picked the right side. Before I do anything... Well, the exit is right there, so... But yeah, just in case putting that checkpoint. Alright, that worked well. And then... Well, this seems like it's the last level. Well, the last of the Remits levels. Maybe what you get when you get 100% is like a Remits version of the last level or some shit like that. Probably. Maybe. Will this... Wow, really? I missed that? Well, screw you, Mr. Game. Right. Oh, the sad faces. The sound effect is a little bit funny. When you make them smile. Right? Oh, that kills you! Well, pretty nice of you. Damn it. Come on. There are almost no iframes on that thing. Well, it makes sense since it's supposed to be an unnatural reaction. Really? Right, don't get hit by this. What about that? This is where I die. That's supposed to be an obstacle, and so is that one. Why the little detail? Okay. Okay, and what is this? Wait, are these teleports completely random or what? Oh, you're supposed to avoid those. I'm dead. I should have set a checkpoint there. A little bit late for that, but yeah. Okay, I need to remember setting a checkpoint before that section. I mean, you come from a section where you're supposed to hit every teleport, and you go into a section where you're supposed to avoid the teleports. You can at least put them a different color. Well, technically, the functionality is still the same, just that it goes, it doesn't go in your favor. Okay. Set a checkpoint here, there you go. And now, this is avoiding these things. So I must... Okay, but that's something that you need to get. Okay, I guess you were only supposed to avoid the ones on the bottom. Okay, that's fine. Okay. Oh, there's a teleport here too. Ah, really? What the hell? Damn, the platform disappeared regardless. That's messed up. Uh-oh. I'm gonna... Oh, I can't set a checkpoint here. God damn it. I messed up. Could have set a checkpoint before this. Since this is a falling platform, you can't. Damn it. Oh, I thought that I failed. Okay, I can at least set a checkpoint there. But it was easier to go the other way, I think. Yeah, whatever. Okay. is the rolling thingy with a teleport at the end of it. Damn, I got the gold medal. Can't believe it. I got the gold medal on the last level. And look at that cheering. Wasn't expecting the very last one to get the one that I get it on. Is there something new in the playground, by the way? Because I only visited it once. I think that the playground is, well, just as the name suggests, a place where you can play around and practice the physics. Because I don't think there's anything else. I mean, you just have some little dialogue with these guys, but it's just supposed to be a place where you do that. Yeah, see here, you practice the controls in this place. You don't do really anything else. Well, in that case, I think that that's a good place to finish, to end with this game. I mean, I could try going for the gold medals here, but I think it's gonna be a bad idea, and you're gonna see why very quickly. Well, first of all, if you want the gold medals, you should do this. If you die, you need to restart, because it's useless to respawn, because you're gonna lose time. But you will see why it's a bad idea. So this is the first level, right? And it's supposedly the easiest. If I already start like this, that's some bad start. But see, this is what I'm talking about. Even the first level will be a pain in the ass. You can imagine that the other ones are even gonna be... they're gonna be even more painful. That's the thing. I will still try it once, but just want to illustrate my point. Well, mostly because I'm pretty sure that here you are intended to use the wheel at all times. If you don't use the wheel, you're probably... well, not here, since there's not much you can do about it. Oh, did I really die there? Hey, that's what I'm talking about. I'll still try to get at least one clean run until the end. You will see that even then, I'm probably not gonna get the gold medal. That's the thing, when you're going for this type of challenges... wait, cannot you just jump there from here? You'll be able to, right? Yeah, you can. Not sure if that's faster, but it works. Tell you to set a checkpoint here, but I'm afraid that setting a checkpoint here wouldn't do shit. So I have the dead restart enabled. I actually get the gold medal here. Damn. I guess my point didn't get very illustrated here. Fuck. Damn it, now I'm forced to try hard everything else. I don't believe it. I guess I could give it a try. But damn, unbelievable. So you can actually not be that fast. You can waste a lot of time and you can still make it. Because right there, I wasted a lot of time. I still got a gold medal out of it, so... I guess the game... Like, the gold medals are meant for shitters like me. We don't feel that bad about being bad. The amount of time that I wasted there, even if I didn't die, it wouldn't have been possible. I'm not sure if it's faster to go here or the other way. I feel like the other way is faster. I don't see any reason for this place to be faster. I'm not even sure what's the point of that place. Well, maybe to pick up candies. But like, I feel like going here should be faster. I mean, there are less obstacles. It's more straightforward. I don't think there's absolutely any reason to even care about that other path. I should care about this. This evil conveyor belts. Well, the conveyor belts are not the issue. It's the rotating blades that are the issue. Or if you can do this part. Well, I guess you can do it faster like that. Now, oh, down here. Can just skip this. The gold medal? Oh, I remember this part that you needed to get to this ring race. Oh, through this ring race, I mean. So otherwise you can't continue. It's pretty weird because aside from the remits levels, this gimmick kinda is only used here. But yeah. Little bit weird that that's the case, but why not? To mention that there are quite a lot of rings. Ah, damn it. Yeah, I'm definitely not gonna make it to the gold medal. Maybe I can get it to the silver? No, I don't think so. Well, if I can finish... No. I could have, I guess, if I was less of a coward and actually used the wheel more. But yeah, that's the thing. See, in this level, I mean, there are a lot of places that I went slower than I should have. But... Yeah, it requires some tryharding that I don't think I'm willing to give it. So I think that for me, that's where I'm gonna finish. Because yeah, getting gold medal in everything seems like an absolute pain in the ass. But hey, the game was cool. Pretty short. And, you know, it's pretty cheap on Steam too. And if you're the kind of person that loves speedrunning and that sort of shit, I'm sure that you will love something like this. But yeah, when it comes to me, I think I prefer not doing it. But yeah, at least what the rest that I did was cool. So yeah, I think that's gonna be it for me for today as well. So thanks everyone a lot for watching, and I'll be seeing you on the next stream with something else. So have a good one everyone, and take care.